Whether you're creating content or watching content, I think we're all acutely aware of the impact that music has on the videos that we watch. But I wanted to try and put this to a test even more. So I grabbed a bunch of video clips from pexels.com, a free stock shot site, and a big shout out to Taryn Elliot for allowing me to use these clips. And I put them together into a sequence, and then I added different music. So let's first have a listen to horror soundtrack. Next, let's go for orchestral, hopeful, inspirational style music. And finally, let's end with a hip-hop beat. Obviously, the filters do have an impact on how you perceive the video as well, but I think the music helps you to decide on the kind of look that you'll eventually add to your video anyway. So I kind of see them as hand in hand. But I hope after watching the three different videos, you're able to see how it affects the tone of the video, it affects the emotion and how you feel, and it also has a big impact on the storytelling. In this video, what I want to talk about is the importance of copyright music. I want to have a look at where I get my music from, and then I want to show you a little bit of music editing using CapCut. Copyright is an area that you could spend days talking about on YouTube, and it's not something that I want to get into at the moment. But I suppose in my mind, what I try to do is not use anything that I haven't made or that I don't have permission to make or that isn't Creative Commons. And, you know, Reels and TikTok have kind of mixed this up a bit, where they kind of got blanket licenses for all of us to use really popular music. But every time I choose one of these tracks, I'm like, this is just, I don't know if I should be doing this. I don't know if the rules will change in the future and they'll actually take the music away from my video. So I would never use popular music on a video that I want to be relevant in the future. Now, I got bitten in the bum by this because I was making a Canva demo a couple of years ago and I used some of the Canva music in the video. I uploaded the video to YouTube. The video got 125,000 views, my most popular video so far. It got me 1,500 subscribers to my YouTube channel, which helped me become a partner. But it was only recently that I looked at the monetization of this and I was like, it's ineligible. Why is this ineligible? And then I checked the details and I realized that there's a song used for less than 30 seconds, but it's owned by Epidemic Sounds. So I'm leaving money on the table by not checking this and making sure that I used a copyright track from the very beginning. So where do I find my music, you might ask? And the one thing that I would say is YouTube Audio Library has been an amazing resource for me the whole time. So, you know, go to your channel on YouTube, click on your icon on the top right, click on YouTube Studio, and then scroll down to the bottom left and click on Audio Library. How I search this is I usually click this and click Attribution Not Required, meaning that I don't have to thank the author or the song composer or writer for using the song. And then I might go into Mood usually, click Inspirational, hit Apply, and then listen to a few tracks until I'm happy with the one that I have. More recently, I've started using CapCut's audio library. So go into CapCut, click on Audio, and click on Music, and make sure that Commercial is selected. Now in here, you kind of have to describe the song that you're looking for. So if I type in Inspirational Rock, then I can click on the song and listen to it for a few seconds and see if I like it. And there are actually really good tracks in here. I feel like I've run out of tracks on YouTube Audio Library, so I'm really happy that CapCut has Commercial Sounds now included in its videos. And I have uploaded a number of these videos to YouTube and haven't received a copyright strike. So fingers crossed it will stay this way. Another way that I have found music in the past is, especially with Irish artists who aren't yet, you know, extremely popular, if I find a song that I really like that is by a lesser known artist, I will email the artist and say, hey there, I came across this song. I'm making a video about da 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 for my YouTube channel link. Would there be any chance that I could use your song, and I will credit you at the end of the video and in the description? And recently I got to use a really cool song that I really, really loved in a video that I made. So, you know, it's worth asking if you're up for it. And I would definitely suggest doing that. And then the final way that I'm going to suggest, which isn't quite ready yet, it's using something like Beatoven.ai. Now, I did test out a few of these. I liked Beatoven's interface. It's almost like ChatGPT, but for music. So describe the music that you want. You can include the duration, vibe, era, and occasion. So I'm going to say, please make me a 1 minute loopable song for a YouTube video. Click compose track and see what it creates for you. I mean, it's not quite there yet, but bear in mind how early we are on the AI life cycle, you know, how good this is going to be in the future. And also bear in mind that my prompt wasn't probably very good. So I need to get better at prompting while at the same time AI improves its ability to generate results from that prompt. So I am very excited about that in the future. So now I'm going to start a new project in CapCut, and I'm going to bring in those shots that I got from Pexels. And I'm just going to drag them onto the timeline in any sequence at all. So now I'll go into audio, music, and then I'll go for fashion, maybe, because I think that this kind of looks like it could be a clothing advertisement, slow-mo running through a forest, wearing a watch and a dress supplied by the company. But I definitely want to pick a track that I actually like to listen to, because by the time you finish editing, you'll have listened to the song like 100,000 times. So you'll be really, really sick of it if you don't like it. Let me just drag this lo-fi hip-hop straight onto the timeline, and that is a minute long, which is fine. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do, which I love about CapCut, another one of the things that I love about CapCut, is I'm going to click on the music and then click this guy here, which says mark beats. If I click beats 1, it will mark the most relevant beats or the biggest beats. And if I click beats 2, it will double the amount of beats in the song. So let me just go back to beat 1. And then what I'll do is I will make my clips end exactly at the beat. Maybe you shouldn't be editing to the beat of the song or making your cuts exactly on the beat, but it's a very quick way to get started with your edit. So I'll just hover over it, get the grab tool, and then just pull that to the beat of the song. And now we can see how that sounds. So I've just removed a couple of the clips and done just a very, very quick edit. But you can see how quickly you can just edit to the beat of the song without having to try and like see the waveforms and where the beat starts, which is very cumbersome. But this just does it for you. Or, well, it kind of tells you where the beats are, puts a marker where the beat is, and allows you to snap in to that so that your clip ends and your next clip will start. Another thing that I want to talk about is the level. So over here, we can actually see how loud the music is. And it's coming up to about halfway. If we were to actually turn the music up, we can see it goes into orange. And then if we turn it up even further, now it's going into red, which means that the song is being clipped. So you're actually losing a lot of the sounds from the song because they are just too noisy for the speaker to be able to understand. So let me just turn that down a little bit more. But say, for example, you had a voiceover or a piece to camera somewhere from here to here, and then it goes back into the person walking or running. So what I do is I keep the song high here, and then I want to turn the song down here and then turn it up again here. And how you do this is by doing what's called keyframing. So in here now, I'll just make sure that the level is good. So imagine the voiceover is just about to start. What I'm going to do is add a key or a signal to the editor that at this point in time, I want the volume of the song to be 4.5. Then I'll move the ruler along a little bit and I will add a key again. And then I will turn the song down to say minus 20. Now I'm just guessing, but you can see how it actually changes the waveforms down here. Now I'll go back to when the voiceover finishes, even though there isn't actually a voiceover here, and I will turn it back up to 4.5. Now let's listen. And now the voiceover would fit in well before the song picks up again. Great. Okay, now let's talk about ending a song, because, you know, what a lot of people do is they'll get to the end of the clip, they'll chop it off, delete, and then have their video end like this. What kind of intermediate maybe editors might do is they might grab the audio or grab the music file and add a fade out. Look at the hill appearing there on the waveform. So that's like an automatic keyframe for it to fade out without having to actually mess with the keyframes. Better, but not the best. What I would do in this situation is I would actually drag the music track the whole way out, make sure to grab it on a beat actually, because that will save you time later. Grab the end of the track and pull it to around here. Then you can cut off your track at around there. Try and get the marker on the marker and then just add a little bit of a handle on the end of the first part of the track and the start of the new part of the track. Add a fade in to this part, add a fade out to that part, and now, fingers crossed, it sounds okay. And now the song ends as the video ends, and it is just a million times better. Okay. I am extremely tired today and I'm really happy that I got through this video, because I really am delighted to share this information with you. So what we covered is the same sequence of clips with different music added and a different filter on each one, and how that evokes different emotions and tells a different story. Then we looked at my rookie move of adding non-copyright music to a video that I uploaded to YouTube that became my most popular video, and now I don't earn any money off that video. I think, change the music, so I'm going to look into that next week. Then we took a look at YouTube Audio Library, which used to be my go-to place. Now I'm using more CapCut Audio Library, which I think is really good, and I haven't got in trouble for using it yet. Then we had a look at editing music by dropping it into the timeline, adding AI beats using CapCut, editing the clips to the beat of the song, using keyframes to turn it down and turn it up at different levels, and making sure that the ending is nice and smooth so that the music ends, so that the video ends as your music ends, which always makes a more professional and seamless edit. So I hope this has been of benefit to you. If it has, please put your comments in the description below. Please put your comments in the comments section below. And also, I'm always looking for new resources to find free music, but if you do add them to the comments, please make sure that you've tested them by uploading them to YouTube and like can almost be certain that nobody's going to get a copyright strike or their video to be demonetized for using them on any platform. Thanks a million for watching, and I will see you next week.